Hello students,
our next topic is a spring gun and its initial conditions.
So this is a spring gun. Here a marble of mass M is attached by means of a string which is connected to a piston of mass M. Okay, this is the equilibrium position of the spring and the piston, and this is the particle or the marble which is fired using the spring gun. Okay, so a spring gun fires a marble of mass M by means of a spring and piston in a barrel as shown. The piston has mass M and it is attached to the end of a spring having a spring constant K. The piston and marble are pulled back a distance L from the equilibrium and released. So this is pulled back to a distance L. In the negative x direction, it is pulled back to a distance L from the equilibrium and released. The problem is to find the speed of the marble just as it loses contact with the piston. So, you have to find out the speed of the marble, speed of this mass M, as it just loses its contact with the piston. Gravity and friction are neglected. So we take the x-axis to be along the direction of motion and the origin to be at the spring's unstretched position, that is x0. The position of the piston obeys the equation of motion, simple harmonic motion. You know the equation of motion, m plus m, here we have mass m plus m, d square x by dt square plus kx equal to 0. So when we divide this equation by m plus m, we get the simple harmonic equation as d square x by dt square plus k by m plus m, x is equal to 0. Or its general solution will be x of t is equal to a sin omega t plus b cos omega t, where omega here it is root of k by m plus m. And the velocity is found out by differentiating the position equation. So, from this equation, you get v of t is equal to x dot t. So, it is omega a cos t, cos omega t minus omega b sin omega t. So, this is the equation of velocity. Now, we have to find out the constants a and b using the initial conditions. We know that at x, at t is equal to 0, the position is at minus 11. It is stretched to a distance L to, opposite to the movement. So it is minus L, and V, the velocity at time t equal to 0 is 0. Okay. So substituting these two initial conditions in these equations, we get in the, from this equation, x at t equal to 0, the position is minus L, that is equal to A sin omega 0 plus B cos omega 0. So this term is at 0. So you get cos omega, cos 0 is 1. So you get B is equal to minus L. So you get one constant, B is equal to minus L. And you substitute the same condition in this equation for V of t equal to 0. So at velocity, the velocity at time t equal to 0 is 0. So V of 0 is equal to 0. That is equal to omega A cos omega 0 minus omega B sin omega 0. So here this term is 0. So this is only omega A is equal to 0, or A is equal to 0. So you got the two constants, A equal to 0 and B equal to minus L. So our solution will be position x of t is equal to minus L cos omega t and velocity v of t is equal to omega L sin omega t. Our solution holds until the marble and piston loses its contact. The piston can only push the marble, but it cannot pull. So when the piston begins to slow down, the contact is lost and the marble moves at constant velocity. So from this equation, from equation 4, we see that at time t equal to tm, at which velocity reaches the maximum value when it crosses the equilibrium position. Okay, that is the time where the velocity is maximum. That is, in this equation, you get when omega tm is equal to pi by 2. This is the maximum value. So, when omega tm is equal to pi by 2, we find the position as xtm is equal to minus l cos
pi by 2, that is equal to 0, which is the equilibrium position. Okay. Now the marble loses contact as the spring passes its equilibrium position as we expect. Since the spring force retards the piston for x greater than 0. So from equation 4, the final speed of the marble will be V max is equal to V at the time Tn. Is the velocity, the maximum velocity with which the marble moves is the velocity at the time Tn. So that is equal to, substitute for Tm, omega L sin pi by 2. So sin pi by 2 is 1, and we substitute omega, that is equal to root of k by m plus m into L. So this is the final speed of the marble when it just loses contact with the spring, that is when it passes across the equilibrium point. So this is the final speed of the marble. Now for high speeds, for the maximum value, in order to increase the value, you need k and l to be larger and m plus m in the denominator should be small. So in other words, to get high speed, use a small projectile and pull on the spring gun as hard as you can. So L should be maximized and M should be minimized. The answer is this is the solution.